Hello students, in last videos we have already studied what are the derivatives of carboxylic acids. Now we'll see what is the relative reactivities of acid derivatives. So that means we studied for example acid derivatives like acid halides, anhydrides, esters and amides. Okay, so among four, which is highly reactive or which is highly stable, we'll study. So those relative reactivities of this carboxylic acid derivatives can be studied with respect to the nucleophilic substitution reaction. So by taking the example of basic hydrolysis, so we'll see which is highly reactive among those four. Okay, so that is the general formula. Here it is G is given as a general group for the anhydrous. Anhydrous are to the esters group, are to the halogens and amines. Okay, when you treat those acid derivatives with base, that is maybe sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, etc. When you treat with those bases, where those OH group is going to replace this functional group, as a result, we are going to get the corresponding acid and the leaving group. Okay, so among those four derivatives, which of the compounds going to react very fast, we'll study that. So those can be explained by the two factors. So those depends on the two factor, that is one is electronegativity and another one is resonance stabilization. So we'll see what is that. Okay, first one, that is electronegativity. So we already know that. So this G groups are all are functional group like halogens, esters, anhydrides, amides. Okay, so if those are having greater electronegativity like this, if it is G is halogens, for example, G is halogens. Halogens are highly electronegative. We already know that. So since they are highly electronegative, which withdraws or which pulls this bonded pair electron towards itself, as a result, so attack of nucleophilic will be very easy. So that is electron, since this carbon become electron deficient, which facilitates the nucleophilic attack. So this bond is going to break very easily. So generally we can say that if that is G, that functional groups are highly electronegative, so which facilitate the nucleophilic attack very easily. So among four functional group like halogens, anhydrides and esters in amines group, okay, halogens are highly electronegative, then comes anhydrides, then comes ester. So among oxygen and nitrogen, oxygen is highly electronegative, then comes nitrogen, that's why. And there is a confusion here, it is also oxygen, here also oxygen, but in the case of anhydrides there is a one more carbonyl carbon, so which withdraws the electron towards itself, as a result breaking of this bond becomes very easy. That's why after halogens there is anhydrides, next is ester, next is amine. So based on this electronegativity, we can say that halides are most reactive and amides are least reactive to the nucleophilic reagent. We'll see one more, that is resonance stabilization. So where resonance stabilization mainly depends on the lone pair electron which is present in the functional group. So that is G. Here we can see so which should donate electron towards the carbonyl carbon, towards this, to form a pi bond. So for example, if it is halogens also have lone pair electron, but since they are highly electronegative, they do not donate its lone pair electron easily to the resonance stabilization. So we can say if lesser the electronegativity, they'll easily donate lone pair electron towards to the resonance. So among four, in previous step only we came to know that among four, where amines are less electronegative, so as a result they'll easily donate that's lone pair electron towards the resonance stabilization. So they are highly stable compounds. So we'll see that is one by one, that is acid halides or acid chlorides. They have least stabilized carbonyl group because delocalization of lone pair electron on Cl to the carbonyl group is not effective because of the higher electronegativity of this halogen. So if this is a halogen, as I said, since they are highly electronegative, they do not easily donate their lone pair electron towards the resonance stabilization. Though that's why this is the least stable. So usually acid halides are least stable. Then comes in acid anhydride. So similarly, in the case of acid anhydride, oxygen is already having lone pair electron, although which is having lone pair electron which donates to the resonance stabilization. But the thing is, which is having two carbonyl group, which should donate its lone pair electron to the two both the side of the carbonyl group. So as a result, which makes the, since it has to donate its lone pair electron to the both the side, so this becomes once again little unstable compared to the ester. In the case of esters also, what we have is oxygen only. Here what we have is oxygen only. In the case of anhydrides also oxygen only. But the thing is, here oxygen which donates its lone pair electron to the only one carbonyl group, but in the case of anhydrides, which should donate to the this carbonyl group as well as this carbonyl group. As a result, where anhydrides are less stable compared to that of ester. So then comes amide. So in the case of amides, obviously we came to know that that is the compared to oxygen, where nitrogens are less electronegative, as a result which easily donate such lone pair electron towards the resonance stabilization. As a result, compared to among three, amides are highly stable. So a high degree of stabilization result in the slower nucleophilic attack. Hence the reactivity of acid halide acid derivatives with the nucleophilic result follows this order. So where the stability or the reactivity is highest in the case of acid halides, next is anhydrides, and the next is esters, next is amides. So in other words, we can say relative stability order. So among four, stable is amides, then comes ester, then comes anhydrides, then come halides. So based on these two factors, one can say which derivative is highly stable or which is highly reactive. So I hope you understand. Thank you.